Good morning, children. Welcome back to English class. Today's topic is Course Book Chapter 10, The Wind and the Leaves. It's a poem written by George Cooper, an American poet. It is a nature poem about seasons and how one season changes to another. So children, how many seasons do we have? We have summer season, winter season, spring season, autumn season. We enjoy all the seasons and celebrate many festivals through the year. There are three stanzas in this poem. Each stanza contains four lines. In this poem, the wind calls the red and gold autumn leaves as summer is gone and the days are getting cold. On hearing the wind's loud call, the leaves flutter over the brown fields, singing their soft little songs. They are content to sleep on earthy beds with the snow as their blanket. Children, please look at page number 67 in your course book. There you may color the leaves on the trees according to the different seasons. In summer seasons, you can see that the leaves are green in color. And in the autumn season, you can see the trees are going to shed their leaves. And it is red and brown, yellow and golden color. And in the spring season, the leaves are growing, started to grow. In winter season, the leaves are dry and covered with snow. Now, all of you listen to this poem and find out what the wind said to the leaves. Come, little leaves, said the wind one day. Come o'er the meadows with me and play. Put on your dresses of red and gold, for summer is gone and the days grow old. Here, the wind asked the leaves to come away with it and play. He is calling the leaves to play with him. It says that summer is gone, and it is autumn now. Autumn means the weather begins to get colder. Autumn is the time when trees shed their leaves. That is, the leaves change from green to red, orange, yellow or brown before falling. Have you noticed it, children? So who is calling the leaves? The wind is calling the leaves. And what color are the leaves? The leaves are red and golden color now because it is autumn season. Move to second stanza. Soon as the leaves heard the wind's loud call, down they came fluttering one and all. O'er the brown field then they danced and flew, singing the soft little songs they knew. So what's the meaning of fluttering, moving in an irregular motion? When the leaves heard the wind's call, they started fluttering. That means they started to fall down. They fly over brown fields making a rustling sound. So that means they are singing soft little songs. That means they are making the sound and they were dancing and fall down. Move to last stanza. Dancing and whirling the little leaves went. Winter had called them and they were content. Soon fast asleep on their earthy beds, the snow laid a coverlet o'er their heads. Meaning of whirling is rapidly moving in a circular motion. And content means satisfied. Coverlet means a bedspread. Here the poet explains how the leaves whirl and dance with the wind. When the wind calls the leaves, they were dancing and whirling. Because summer has entered and their winter has arrived. And what is the specialty of this winter? They bring snow with it. The wind stops and the leaves fall to the ground where they are covered by a snowy bed. And these earthy beds with the snow used as their blanket. So children, hope you understood the meaning of this poem. You have seen that how the seasons changes to another and how the leaves responded to the wind's call. Read this poem and learn it. That's all for today. Next class we will discuss workbook. Be ready with that. Children, don't forget to complete your work. We will meet you next class. Till then, take care. Thank you.